Hi! Want to learn how to create a beautiful animated e-greetings like this right inside PowerPoint? You can email this e-greetings by sticking the greetings right in the body of your email, and your recipients don't need to have PowerPoint to open and see your creation. You can WhatsApp this, post it on any social media, and definitely get your viewers' attention. Want to learn how to create this? I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Step one is to download the illustrations right within PowerPoint. Go to Insert, Pictures, Stock Images, Illustrations, search for Flowers, select what you want, and hit Insert. Don't have the Illustrations tab in your PowerPoint? Then download these illustrations from sites like freepik.com. Step two, right-click on the individual images, convert to shape, select the individual elements, and then color them to your heart's content and make sure that everything looks beautiful. Once you're happy with the colors, select everything and group it by pressing Ctrl G. Step 3, arrange the elements that you've just colored and grouped on your slide according to your preference. In this case, I've copied this element a couple of times and placed it on the slide by just rotating it a little bit. As you can see here, I'm not placing everything right inside the slide area. They are a little bit outside because they are going to enter in with an animation. Step 4, apply animation. It's a very simple combination of fly-in animation followed by a spin animation. Let me show you for one. I'm going to repeat the same animation for the remaining ones as well. Select the object, fly-in animation from top right. Increase the duration to 2 seconds. Start of the animation is with previous. Select the same object, add animation, spin animation. Increase the duration to 2.5 seconds, and this happens with previous. Then open the effect options, change the amount to 10 degrees custom and hit enter. Auto reverse, timing, say until end of slide and say okay. Now when I go to slideshow, this is how the animation happens. It flies in and then rocks by 10 degrees up and down. Once you're happy with this, you select this, double click on the animation painter, you apply the same thing for this one and the other one. Then you hit escape to get your cursor back. We are going to just change the direction. The fly-in needs to happen from bottom, so I'm going to select the fly-in animation and change the direction to from bottom, and the same thing applies to this one as well. When I go to slideshow, this is how the animation looks so far. Now, to these leaves, I'm going to apply just the spin animation. Go to add animation, say spin animation. Increase the duration to 5 seconds and hit enter. Happens with previous. Open the effect options. And this time, we're going to change the amount to 7 degrees and hit enter. Auto reverse, timing, and say repeat until end of slide and say OK. Now, a whole bunch of animations are happening all at the same time. We just need to add a bit of delay so various animations happen at different times to make it look a lot more lively. So select this, make it 0.25 seconds delay, select another one at random and increase it to 0.5, and make another one, change it to 0.75. Make sure that you mix things up so they all enter at different times onto the slide and give it a nice effect. Now when I go to slideshow, this is how the various elements enter the scene at different times. Rock at different pace in different angles. The next step is to insert your text elements. Whatever you want to write, you can write. I've used 3 separate text boxes, used a handwritten font, and really increased the size. Of course, you want to introduce them onto the scene with a simple animation. So let us select each of these elements and apply a simple fade-in animation. And they all happen with previous. And we are going to vary the entry time by adding a bit of delay like this. So everything looks a little bit dramatic. When I go to slideshow, this is how it looks at this point. Now we are pretty much there. Just to add a bit of sparkle to this e-greetings, I'm going to use an animated GIF from jiffy.com. So let us go to Jiffy, and you can see that there are quite a few options available for your transparent starburst animation. Let me right click on this, copy the image, and then I can stick it onto my slide and it'll play right away. Let me make multiple copies of this and place it all over the text. So let us press Ctrl D a couple of times, and then let us place this one over here, another one over here, another one here. Now when I go to slideshow, you can see that this is how the greetings looks. Now the last step is to save this as an animated GIF. So go to File, Export, Create an Animated GIF, keep the size as medium, check Make Background Transparent and say Create GIF. Choose a folder and give it a name and save. Then open your email. On the body of the email, you can copy the file from the place where you have downloaded, say copy, and then right click and paste it. And there you have a beautiful eGreetings right inside the body of your email. Want to learn how I created an animated video in PowerPoint, which now has more than 1 million views on YouTube? Click on the link here and watch the video right now. It's a fun video and will teach you a thing or two about PowerPoint animations. Go ahead, click on the link and start watching the video right now.